the official DJ Super Raveman, and welcome to part 5 of Illusion of Time, Sky Garden to the Ocean Palace. So, let's go and conquer Sky Garden. Sky Garden was actually the first idea. Well, let's just read this. We meet again! Your strong boy to come this far. Or to have come this far. The Sky Garden is our mode of transportation. There are 4 crystal balls in 4 locations. Find each one in clockwise order. Thank you, Mr. Moontrap. Drop off the cliff at the front and back to find the upside down world. Right, yeah, so you don't go that side, you don't go down here, and you don't go down there, you gotta go through here. So let's go through here. And we're gonna head down. And there. These enemies, they act like bombs, you know, when they fall down, but the string, they either look like pieces of shit, like someone just took a long dump, or they look like aim beads. It's quite funny. Here's the terminators. And they even fire their rocket fists. It's like a super rocket fist. And they shoot laser beams as well. Now, they look like they're made out of, not like metal, but crystal. Now, the Moon Tribe just said about that they use the Sky Garden as their mode of transportation. Which is odd. This game is actually mentioning aliens. So the Moon Tribe are probably not even human. They're actually alien. And yeah, maybe, who knows? But them using the Sky Garden to travel is obviously blatantly saying that the Sky Garden is a ship, which is quite weird. We gonna get there. Red Jewel. Wahey! Yeah, and as you see, I got 6 herbs, I think. Now, hang on. 2, 4, 7. Yeah. Yeah, I think it's best. 2. Yeah, 6 herbs. I did try to record before, but somehow there was a problem. When I reloaded back, I was all the way back to before I had to go to the diamond, so I had to redo it. Thankfully, it's like as if Zedsnez knew that I'd forgotten something, which I did. In Frisia, there is a, you know, like all the little white fence areas, they got flowers. One of those areas you can drop down and then you'll find another labor trader guy, and if you speak to him, he will give you a red jewel. Now, I didn't remember that until when I had re-recorded this. So, yeah. I've gone through Sky Garden basically twice. So this time, everything is going well. I might have accidentally cancelled the recording, I don't know. But this time around, there's going to be no problems. I think it's also because someone was messaging me on my phone, so I had to kind of pause. Go to the menu of Zedsnez and then reply to this goddamn message that kept coming through. I think that's what probably screwed it all up. But yeah, that ain't gonna happen this time. Because even if my phone goes off, I'm not bothering looking at it. Because I got this. So yeah, Skygon. As you can see, one of the Moon Tribe said that if you go from the top, the front, and then you jump down, you'll go down by the back. And you see that? That looks like an enemy monster. Well, it's like a screaming face. Weird. It's the animation when an enemy dies. You just see this like screaming face, like. Well, we got herbs, and now we have 7 herbs. And as you have noticed and have been watching, you've witnessed that I have not used 1 herb yet, so I've still got them all. That's brilliant. A long time ago when I was doing a test for a playthrough, I was so far through Illusion Time and I was at Sky Garden, and I decided to think of maybe I should try a little test thing of showing Sky Garden me go through it. And yeah, okay, the video didn't have that many views, but after a while I was thinking, well, I gotta do a playthrough, there's something I've always wanted to do. So if you've noticed on my YouTube channel, that Sky Garden walkthrough has been deleted. Sorry about that, but there's no point in me having that first attempt and then this attempt on the same thing. Well, yeah, you get what I mean. There is a lot of enemies, and obviously when you go from the front and back, the enemies are the same, but they're different coloured, and obviously they aren't like recycled enemies anyway. They kind of look it, but they do attack differently. So we have got the first crystal orb, thankfully. Now obviously in Sky Garden there is 4 sections, which you've seen. There's 4 crystal orbs, so there's 4 areas. Each area is more complex, but it's not too complex as impossible to complete, because it is actually quite simple. But every single time I do an area, I'm gonna save, because if I don't save then, and I die or something, then I'm just gonna be absolutely pissed. But yeah, one thing I am gonna try and make sure of is that, one, I don't use a herb in this area or this whole place, even with the bobs, and also that I don't even die. I wonder if I can do that. If I can, then that is cool. If not, then we'll just lose one of those heart things, like continues or whatever they are. So let's go and take out the next Rocky Fist Terminator guy. Now the first part of this playthrough has got 28 views so far. That is pretty cool. I mean, I don't expect my videos to get thousands upon thousands upon thousands of views, but if I do, then that is absolutely amazing. It obviously will show that my channel started to grow even bigger. I am possibly going to do another playthrough of another game after I've done Illusion Time, but before I do that next other playthrough, I'm gonna start making some more remixes, because I haven't been making any remixes because I've been doing this playthrough, and obviously I can't tackle all of it at the same time. I hope you don't mind that. So don't worry, the remixes are still gonna be commander ding song at any time, and I have absolutely tons of remixes to do anyway. So, yeah. we are, well, we've become Free Dan now, so yeah, I'm gonna head up here and take out this enemy. Now, in the majority of Sky Garden, you can do it without Will. You can do most of it with Free Dan, but there is certain sections that you need Will for his Psycho Dash. Other than that, you're more than welcome to just stick with Free Dan. And plus, the music in this is absolutely amazing. I absolutely, literally adore the music in this game because it is brilliant. Probably notice I've already done a remix on Sky Garden. I think I did a pretty solid job. But if I didn't, then I will do my best to kind of redo a certain section. Well, you know, make a second remix if I feel that I should. If I don't feel I should, then I won't bother. But yeah, I was thinking that maybe I should just do Sky Garden and then I'll save and end the video, but I think that wouldn't be so fair, and obviously it'd be probably quite short, I'm not too sure, but I'm thinking perhaps what I could do is after I've been to Sky Garden, there's another section that will come up in further in the game, which will be the Ocean Palace. I'm not exactly revealing too much about the Ocean Palace or what comes after that. So I'll reveal that next bit later on. This video, perhaps, or maybe in the next. But we now have the crystal ball. Da-da-da-da-da. I wonder if I can make it without more damage. Ah, balls. Those balls hit me anyway. Fuckers. The best thing about this area, except for the music, is the amount of upgrades you get. So you get like defense, strength, HP, and those kind of upgrades are quite. There's quite a lot of them in this area. Right, I'll talk about some other things out of that are not part of Ocean Town. So a while back, when I used to have my Xbox 360, I had games like Grand Theft Auto 5 and Skyrim and tons of games. And I used to have some old mates, or so-called friends, but they ain't friends with me, I don't hang out with them anymore. But yeah, as you know, I'm gonna save again, and I'm just gonna go to the next sections. But yeah, my old supposed friends used to knock on the door, I'd answer it, and then they would sometimes just whoop. Try to walk straight in and go, oh, well, Xbox, Mortal Kombat online, yeah. And I'm like, no. And, you know, sometimes they'll walk into the house and they will just go straight to my fridge, or my mother, whatever the house. We went straight to the fridge, and because I used to buy 3 cans of Coke in like a crate. But they came in and they just went and helped themselves, and it just really annoyed me a lot. And they used to take the piss out of me because I didn't have the Xbox One, or I didn't have the up to date TV and stuff, and that really annoyed me. Eventually, they have stopped coming round, probably because I told them to go fuck themselves, or fuck off. I just cannot be asked with them. They're so immature and so annoying. But yeah, but if they were to ever turn up to the house and they were to go, Mortal Kombat, or any other random game they do online or whatever, they have a hard job because I don't have an Xbox 360 anymore. All I have is my Nintendo Wii and my Nintendo 3DS XL, and obviously my laptop, which I obviously made the music on. But on the laptop I have ZSNES. I also have other emulators, which are a PS1 emulator, which is called EPSXE, and there are a few others, which is Visual Boy, I think it is. Yeah, Visual Boy Advance. So that emulator plays Game Boy, Game Boy Color, and Game Boy Advance games. I do have a N64 emulator, but I've got rid of that because I don't. There ain't no point in me having that emulator now, because I've got the 3DS. The only reason I had the emulator was so I could play Ocarina of Time and Majora's Mask. But since they're on the 3DS now, there's no point. So I got rid of that. But yeah, I've completely washed my hands off my so-called mates. They don't ever turn up to the house, and I hope and pray they never do, because I dislike them a lot. They take the piss. They, where all you guys really love my Game Music remixes. They used to say to me, you're making remixes, huh? And they would like take the piss, and then they would say what is it on your YouTube channel? And they're yeah, it is on my YouTube channel. Whatever. And then they would just take the piss, and then eventually they were saying, why don't you just give that shit up, man, and just hang out with us. I thought to myself, no, I have more fucking fun making the remixes than I do actually hanging out with you idiots. All they think about is girls and having sex and getting laid and everything, and they take the piss out of me because I don't have a girlfriend, and I'm being honest, I've never had sex before, so I'm not too bothered about it. But they used to take the piss, and it really pissed me off. They even took me to a massage parlor or whatever it was. They were thinking it'd be funny, and they walk in, get me to stand there, look at the girls, and then they would say, maybe not this one. And they'll go to other, they went to, took me to 3 different massage parlors. And then eventually, one of them was James Nelson. He said to me, I was meant to come down here with Will and then run all across. Well, actually go underneath and then sort everything out, then run down. But instead I went there with Will, came down, and ended up... you understand what I'm just fucked up on. Back to what I was talking about. They took me to this one last massage parlor. They know I have a lot of respect for women, that I don't agree with just using women just for sex. You know, it's not fair. And obviously they just like took me to this place, told me to go look at whatever else, pick one that would be ideal, and then afterwards I would then have to go and tell him that I picked one, and then he would come and then pay his money for it. And I went to him, said, James, there was a girl who, I chose him. I was going to say that to him, but when I walked out, it was not just him, it was him, his younger brother, and his brother's friend as well. So all four of us were there. And when I went out, they all ran, and then got on their car, and then just like drove off. And I was just left there, just looking like a complete bloody idiot. And they made me look like some, I can't explain it, but yeah, it made me feel really embarrassed and really, you know, like, they made me feel so small. And that infuriated me a lot. And eventually when they drove off, but they also then came back and then stopped. And then they were like, "Well, what happened, Lance? What happened?" And they were laughing. And I went, "What the fuck do you think is, what's so funny?" I said, "You just, what the hell?" And I said, "You better go in there and you better apologize to those women. Because I said, that's not very fair." But them being so childish and immature, they just laughed it off as if it was the next funniest thing to do. Where I already have confidence issues with, thinking I'm not good enough for a woman or anything. But yeah, and that really pissed me off. Ever since that, they've never turned up to the house. And thank God for that, because I would rather kill him. I mean, would you let your mates do that to you? But before I get anywhere into that, before we went to the massage parlors, all they said to me was, "Hey Lance, you fancy coming out and just hang out, play some pool?" And I was like, okay. So they got in this car, and we went downtown and to this pub bar area, and then we were having, they got me a drink, and they got themselves one, and then we were playing pool, and then after a while, after playing so long, I was actually quite enjoying myself. It was actually quite nice. I thought, okay, these guys, they're actually not being idiots for once. But then in my mind I was thinking, hang on, something's bound to be gonna happen. But they obviously planning something. And then that's when they were saying about massage parlors, and then they dragged me along going around all these different places. It was annoying. You know, before that, they actually took me to a strip club. They didn't run away, they didn't act so immature that time. One of them actually paid just to get me a lap dance or whatever it was. I enjoyed it. Yeah, it was actually cool. But I also felt real guilty and real bad, because even though some women like to do that as a job, I personally just felt guilty that I just sat down and a woman's just laid all her parts out to me and just like danced. And then it also kind of made me kind of want a woman, like want sex with a woman, like in my mind. But after, I was thinking, well, maybe I should be thinking like this, you know, just don't think like that, because that's what they're trying to do. That's what they were trying to do. They were trying to basically fuck me up. because of like how I feel about using women, and I don't agree with it. But yeah, they were just. I don't want to talk about the show, I guess. So yeah, I don't actually have any proper friends to hang out with. I used to, but as I said, I wash my hands off of them. But yeah, there is. I don't have any more friends to hang out with, so I'm just at home all the time. But there is a girl that I am actually friends with that I don't ever hang out with. I always just see when she's working in the shop that was around the corner from me. I did ask her out once, and she kind of refused. She just said, I'm sorry, but I only like you as a friend. And obviously, I've got uni and other stuff that I've got to deal with, so I'm not really looking for anything at the moment. And I was like, oh, okay. I was actually quite down about it, because I really like her. And yeah. I still, now and again, try to, you know, just ask her out, or just like ask her if she wants to come around and just have a chat and just hang out or something. But she never does. So, despite, you know, she does seem to be caring a lot about me. You know, she wonders how I am and everything. But, yeah, it's just really upsets me, because I've been single for over 6 years and I really like her a lot, but obviously she's about the only one I actually like anyway. You know, there's no other girls around my area or anything that I like. Or shall I say, that like me. Yeah, it's quite weird. But yeah, enough of that. I mean, if she was. I have to get used to it if one day I'm walking about and I see her holding hands with a guy or like kissing a guy, I just think, I said that before, that she's happy and that she's found someone. I mean, it does upset me now, but I have to think about the alternatives. The most important thing I care about my friends is that as long as they're happy, that's good enough for me. And in myself, I have this kind of attitude where I don't care so much about making myself happy, as I actually care about, basically I put other people first before myself. I've always done that, so yeah, if she ends up with someone, I'm just gonna be like, I'm really happy for her. Even though I'll be completely heartbroken, but yeah, I mean, I've had one girlfriend before, but she was evil, I'd say. She had a mentality of a 10-year-old. I didn't even know that at first. I was never told. Until after. I was wondering what that meant. She basically told my sister, when my sister had enough, because my ex-girlfriend was messing me around a lot. Crystal Balls. Yeah, she was just messing me about, and I ended up an emotional wreck, because she played mind games, and basically was driving me bonkers. She got me into that kind of mindset of, I can't explain it, but yeah, she really hurt me as well, and And then when my sister had enough of her little games, my sister went down and said to her, spoke to her and her mum, and said to her, that what is she actually doing? And she said to me, said to my sister that she never actually wanted me. She just wanted to know what it was like to have a boyfriend, so she just thought it'd be funny just to use me. The relationship, even though it was a fake, because she was faking the whole time, but it only lasted for 1 month, 3 weeks, and 4 days. So all of that, I went through hell just in that short amount of time. My head was completely screwed up, and it kind of scared me of ever having a girlfriend. So I've been single now for 6 years. It was 6 years on January 28th. I've been so long, and now I'm ready to look for a girlfriend. I've been trying all different ways of trying to find love, using dating sites and sometimes speaking to someone out in the open, but none of them ever are interested. And it's, I don't just go to them, oh, will you bother me? I'm just like trying to be friendly and speak to them and everything, make them laugh, as sometimes girl likes a guy who makes them laugh. And I do try, but yeah, it just didn't work out. And obviously, this girl that I really like, I've asked her out, and she said that she likes me as a friend. Maybe sometime in the future it might change, but yeah, I think I'm just going to end up staying single for forever, probably. But enough of that. Let's go and take on this boss. Okay, so I'm going to hit ouch. I'm going to try and kill you within this one attempt. Oh god, I've got to better kill him, otherwise I'm going to fucking die. Yes! I found a mystic statue. Lovely. I'm just used to being single now. The way I think, if I find someone, I find someone. If I don't find anyone, then, at least I try. The main thing is, a strange noise fills the air around you. From out of nowhere, you hear Neil's voice. Will, you're falling to the ground. Grab the airplane and we'll fly you out of here. So I'm just going to be... I'm happy I got my music to make and I got YouTube and everything, so I'm fine with it. I'm probably not, but... Shoot! I dropped a contact!
You what, idiot? Well, it's doomed for sure now.
Neil, it's still a little ways to the ground. Try again. Okay, I'll get him this time. That was close. That was a close one. Don't cry. Will's been saved.
Neil, you were great. This invention was Will's rescue or whatever.
Don't flatter me. We should try and locate the next ruins. I expect the shape of sickness is the same as the shape of Moo. Moo. Well, to the ocean.
Moo lies somewhere
in this ocean.
What else can I say? I'm just used to it now, so... If I do end up with that girl I really like, then that'd be sweet, but if not, then never mind. I'm happy. I mean, you guys can probably tell that I sound depressed, and to be honest, I actually am. We got out of the airplane in the nick of time. Neil's a good inventor, but it seems there's always something missing in his inventions. I guess nobody's perfect, including Neil. Yeah, I am depressed. I'm on like 150 milligrams. The next thing he knew, Will was standing in a huge palace. I couldn't remember anything since my water landing. Is everyone safe? Yeah, I'm on 150 milligrams of sertraline, which is an antidepressant. So yeah, they are quite high dose, but hang on. There's a skeleton. Hang on, that skeleton didn't die, just went invisible. That's odd. Even if I touch it, no damage occurs. Yeah. That means that enemy isn't an enemy then. If it doesn't disappear. Yeah, I'm sorry if I've kind of depressed you guys a bit. I just thought I'd, while I was doing Sky Garden and everything, I'd like just talk about some personal things as well. What? A sign of life from the right hand room? Okay, let's go and check this room and see what we can find. Oh, Clara, but she's transparent. That's weird. We got a red jewel. Lovely. Actually, I'll go talk to Clara, I think.
Will? Where is it?
Where is what? I have no idea what she's asking about. Where is it, too? I have no idea what it is. What? I can hear a soft voice from somewhere. This is the Palace of Vampires. The fountain in this place produces demons continuously. Okay. So that's what they are. They're called demons. I'm not gonna attack it, because if it's not trying to attack me and it doesn't hurt me, then it means it's not an enemy. Though it looks like an enemy, so I wonder what's going on. Oh, I skipped that box. Never mind. Let's just head over here and get in this, the vibes in this chest. We found a red jewel. Now, I'm thinking that perhaps all the red jewels are just in the chests in this place, but you never know. I might find something, I might press on the corners or whatever. I'm wasting my time, but oh well. Oh, Eric's an ethereal as well.
What is this place? Dark and lonely. Mother, save me.
And there's another skeleton. Okay.
Hello, brother.
There's quite a few of them. But none of them attack. Balls. That's a bit strange, isn't it? Better head down here.
What? I can hear a soft voice from somewhere. In this basement of the castle is a strange fountain. The stone is there. Hurry! Hurry!
Actually, I don't think that kind of sounds like a soft voice, does it? Oh well. Ooh.
Had a heart attack. I saw Eric in the other room, but something strange. His body is half transparent. I can see through it. And he seems to be unconscious, as if his spirit is lost. Let's stick together. We don't know what will happen. I'll borrow Will's pocket for a while. Well, let's go.
Okay, so we now have Lily with us. So that's alright. She might come in handy a bit later. Who knows? Anyway, let's go over to this area and just... I'm probably getting a bit confused now. Let's see what's over here. Might be something of interest, hopefully. It's weird, but it's like as if this room, there is something to it, that there's something hidden here. It baffles me every single time. Yeah, I will also mention that I haven't got a job. I don't earn any money, really. The only money I actually do get is my job seekers or universal credit. What? A soft? I can hear a soft voice.
The purification stone is in the castle.
Okay. Interesting. Yeah, I've been unemployed since February 2016, so yeah. The only time I actually do earn any kind of money is by you guys. You know, if you really love the remixes and so you want a folder, you just ask, obviously send a small payment or whatever, and I'll sell a bundle of the specific remixes of either whatever game it was and put it into a folder and then upload it to a site where you can download it. But yeah, it's optional. You don't have to pay me, you don't have to give me money or whatever. It's just if you want to. Despite my wish for YouTube to be my kind of job, unfortunately I don't earn any money from it. Like, if you've noticed, when you watch any of my videos, there's no adverts. That's because my videos are not monetized, because my YouTube channel has been slapped, or my AdSense account has been suspended due to invalid click activity. No. I can't seem to open this coffin.
Wait a minute, isn't there a hole in the coffin? I could get in through the hole. I better have a look.
Okay, so what's inside?
There's a key fastened inside this coffin. No wonder it didn't open.
Okay. There was a key in there. So I'm pretty sure that I could get a red jewel from that. Oh, well. Let's open this next one then, shall we? Okay, yeah, she just says the same thing anyway. But she might say something different.
I found a strange stone in this coffin.
You found the purification stone.
If you hear any kind of vibration, like kind of sound, that's because I'm recording my commentary through my mobile phone, the phone recorder. So yeah, that's how I do my commentaries at the moment. I haven't got a proper microphone or anything, so I am going to get that sorted out though, eventually. But yeah, that was just like notifications, probably like, because I'm subscribed to loads of different YouTube channels, so I get like, and I click the bell on those specific channels. They must be asleep. But yeah, there are these enemies around. These are about the only ones you can fight. The notification, the channels I'm subscribed to, I kind of mentioned in a previous video, and obviously I get notifications from that. So if you hear the phone going, then obviously you should know that I'm getting notifications through. It's a bit annoying, but I should have turned the vibration off, but I just can't be bothered. Anyway, we're going to put this stone into the font, or fountain. And the stone disappeared into the fountain's water. Now, it's gone black water, but using this, it will change. To nice blue water again. Which should do something. I'm not saying just yet, but you'll see in a minute. See, there's no enemies? Saved! Thank you! I was brought to this palace from Phrygia and changed to a demon. Nice piece of armor.
What? All the demons we saw before were human beings?
Yeah, the people that were all the enemies we were fighting, they're actually people.
I know what it feels like to be close to death. Death is terrifying. I wonder if the animals we eat feel the same way I felt right before death.
So those skeletons that we saw before, they were actually people. Just changed into demons because of the murky water, and obviously there was like a spell or a curse on the palace that just changed them. Let's see what this guy says.
We were labor traders arrested for the crime of buying and selling human beings. But the party officials sold us to a vampire. I can't believe it.
This is the result of being tempted by a beautiful woman. A nice guy asked me, so I followed him. I don't trust men.
Yeah, yet you're standing next to one. Unknown to them, it was actually the vampires. That tricked them. So we need to run over here and then go upstairs. And then go to this area. There's a guy now.
The man sleeping in this coffin is surely a vampire. They're plotting something.
Well, do you know what? All these people here, they can just, make their lives. You have to start your lives here. Like, I don't know, make this their home. Kind of weird. But it is quite cool, being under the ocean, in a palace. It's weird, but really cool.
A vampire couple lives in the coffins. They bring people here, turn them into demons, and use them for labor.
Yeah, but then why was there three coffins? And when there's only two vampires?
This palace is connected to the land of Mu. The vampires are looking for something there.
What are they looking for? as you just heard, the Land of Mu. That'll be in the next video.
We were always changed into demons. I'm afraid of what might have happened if you had come later.
You would have most probably be fucking dead. Sorry for swearing, but yeah.
Say something like, the mystic statue can be found in Mu.
Okay. We're not sure if there is actually a place called Mu in our world. Never looked it up before. I have to.
I stole a key from the vampire woman. Here, take it. You have received the key to the Seaside Palace.
Yeah. They call it the Seaside Palace, but the actual theme for the Mu is called the Ocean Palace of Mu. It's weird. Okay, so what's this guy say?
On the top floor of the passageway, of the palace, is a passageway leading to Mu.
Yeah, is it a farm? who knew? I have no idea. Right.
What is Mu?
What will we do now, deserted in the middle of the ocean?
No idea.
Maybe we could seize the palace and live there together.
Yeah, you could all bundle together and kind of decorate or whatever. Or just leave it how it looks and live there. I mean, there's nowhere else you can fucking go. You're stuck there. Well, in the next video, in part 6, I will show what is beyond that door. Obviously, they've said the Land of Mu, but you're going to finally be able to see what Mu is in the next episode, next part. So, yeah, as you can see, we got about 5 red jewels. I'm hoping and praying I don't pick up too many more of them. If I do, then I do. Never mind. But I'm going to select this key and I'm going to save, and then I will end the video here, and then I'll see you next time. Thank you for watching and bye bye!
Goodbye!